Hi everyone, and welcome back to the last video of Lesson 4, Level 1. In this video, we'll discuss how to spice up your spreadsheets and make your boring tables of data visually pop so that our important data jumps out at us naturally by using what's referred to as conditional formatting. Up to now, we've discussed relational operators and some Boolean logic. To recap a bit, we used one of the relational operators, the less than operator, in this example to create the first rule. We also talked about the Boolean operators like OR and that helped us out in these rules 2 and 3. Conditional formatting allows us to analyze the value of a cell, and based upon what's in that cell, then we can apply just about any formatting that we want to it. Conditional formatting is found in the Home ribbon in the Styles region, here under this tool, go figure, conditional formatting. Click on this tool and we have several options. The first and most common option is to highlight cells based upon certain rules. There are several predefined wizard-based rules here, such that if a cell is greater than some value, then apply some format. You can also apply a format if the cell's value is less than, between, equal to. We can even check if a chunk of text contains a certain word or phrase. You can also check a date to see if it falls within a certain range, such as today, tomorrow, yesterday, next week, last month, etc. We can also check to see if there are duplicates within a set of data. You can also configure your own rules if you don't like any of those here under More Rules. Another flavor of conditional formatting allows you to format your cell in a certain way if they're in the top 10 or bottom 10 values in a set of cells, or in the top 10%, the bottom 10%, or if they're just above or below average. There's some pretty cool formatting for data bars here. What this does is that it will look at the quantity in a cell and then display a bar visualizing how it compares to a range of cells that it's being compared to. For instance, if we highlight this current credit limit data here in column C and then apply the green data bar to it, we get this. Let me expand this out a little bit to give you a little better view of what it looks like. You can also use color scales here to have the highest values of range be green and the lowest values be red, and all the middle values be some gradual change between red, green, and the middle will probably end up being something like yellow. Let me highlight the current year's sales and apply this formatting with the larger numbers to be green since the bigger numbers are better. Now let me highlight the past due balance cells and apply the color scale where the larger numbers are red since bigger numbers here are bad. Finally, we have icon sets. These are useful if you just want an icon to display the status of a number such as this one here. When a number is in the top one-third of values, it gives you a green arrow up. If it's in the middle third of the values, it'll give you a yellow sideways arrow, and if it's in the bottom third, it'll give you a red down arrow. If you don't like these default values, you can click on the More Rules and alter the breakpoints between the colors, as well as reverse the color scheme from red to green, or vice versa. If you have a cell that already has a rule tied to it and want to add another one, you can click here on New Rule. If you want to clear the rules from a cell or the entire sheet, then you can click here. If you want to add, edit, or delete individual rules, just click on this option here. Let's go over some examples now that we can use to have our data jump out at us a bit. Let's say that we want to have all of the true values here be bold and italicized. We could highlight the entire range, or we can just do it to one test cell. And then once we get it working, we'll copy and paste that format to the entire range. I'll do that one just to show it to you. Let me highlight rule one here on my test account at the bottom, and then go to conditional formatting, add new rule. This dialog box that comes up defaults to format all cells based upon values. We don't want that one because it looks like it just gives us some choices that apply to ranges of numbers. Let's click on this next choice of format only cells that contain. There are several other options that approximately follow the previous menu. For this one, what aspect of the cell do I want to check for? Clicking on the drop-down reveals a list of choices such as specific text, dates, blanks, no blanks, errors, and no errors. We'll just pick cell value for now. Now we go to the next drop-down, and there are all these relational operators here, and I just want equal to, and then in this field, I want true. So that defines what the rule will check and what scenario it will correctly capture. The next step is to select what type of formatting we want to apply to all of our true cells. I want it bold and italics, and here's just that, so I'll pick that one. I'll also pick a filler color of green just for kicks. Please note that if you're going to put this on a black and white printer, you probably don't want to add a bunch of colors as they'll all just wash out to gray. Now let me use the Highlight Cells wizard to add another level of formatting to this same cell. If this cell equals false, then I'll pick one of these choices here. I think I just want this red format here. Now let me test this cell out a bit. If it's true, then we get our green, bold, italicized true. And then if I change it to false, then we get our red wizard-generated format. And if I change it to anything else, it just goes back to no format at all. Let me go outside of the box just a bit to show you another feature of conditional formatting that the book kind of breezes over. If there were another choice here besides true or false that we wanted to check for, let's say we want the cell to turn yellow if a word starts with the letter T. Let me add that cell here. Highlight cells. I don't see one that says text starts with, so I'll go down here to more and add the rule specific text starts with the letter T. Doesn't matter if it's uppercase or lowercase. Now select a background fill of yellow. If we go to manage our rules, see that every new rule gets put up at the top of the stack of rules. The higher up the list it is, then the higher priority it is, and as soon as it's reached from the top down, it applies that format and stops. So if we type in a word that starts with T, then it goes yellow, right? Even if we type in the value of true, then this first rule catches it and turns it yellow, and Excel stops going down the ladder. If we want the value of true to be green and the first letter of T to be yellow, then we need to shift them around in this hierarchy. So let me go back into this manage rules and move the true green rule up to the top, and I'll test it now. True is green. That's cool. Let me put in something starts with T. Timmy. Okay, that turns yellow. False. That's red. That's cool. And let me put an X here, and we get nothing. Now that it works the way I want it, let me paint that format into all of these cells containing all of our true-false rules. Let me also paste the original formula back into my testing cell so that it goes back to normal for future testing if I need to. Let's explore some additional conditional formatting examples. What if we want to apply a special green backfill formatting to the entire row of a customer if that company had a net worth of more than $10 million? First, select the entire company's row, and then go to conditional formatting, and then add a new rule. We want this bottom one here. Use a formula to determine which cells to format. Next, we put our formula here and want to use equals $G22. We put the dollar sign in front of G so that it applies to that entire row. The greater than relational operator, and then a value of 10 million, remembering that this column is in 1,000s, so that actually comes out to 10,000. Let's then select our formatting, fill, I don't know, some shade of green, and hit OK, and then OK again. Notice this row is not formatted since the customer's net worth is under 10 million. If I edit their net worth to 10,001, see what happens? Now this formatting is how I want it, so I'll copy and paint this format into all of these other rows, and we should be good to go. Looks good. If we also want to have a customer's row turn some other color, orange, let's say, if their net worth is less than 400,000, let me highlight our test row and go to conditional formatting, add rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format again. Next, we put our formula in here and we want to use equals $G22, the less than relational operator, and a value of 400,000, which is 400. Let's then select our formatting, fill, some lovely shade of orange, and hit OK and then OK again. We now have our big customers highlighted in green and our smaller ones in orange. Let me just say a caveat here. We probably wouldn't want to employ all of this formatting on a given range of data, as the different formats or visualizations can get overwhelming or confusing if there are too many distracting formats or colors. Please keep in mind that I did all of this on this sheet just to demonstrate most of the conditional formatting functionality built into Excel 2013. That's it for now. See you in the next level.